car, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time now. There'll be an in-depth product presentation tonight. You can take notes then. But I really wanted to show you some of the key features to think about while you're driving the car and maybe test. But beyond that, I will touch a little bit. How many of you have driven an R8 coupe already? So everybody's driven the coupe. Did you have a good experience? Yeah, hopefully you did. The benchmark, obviously, for the Spyder was to keep that performance characteristic of the coupe, which many times is very difficult to do. So as you know, Audi developed this Audi space frame over 20 years ago, and they basically rebuilt it for purpose of the Spyder to keep that structural rigidity. So really test that while you're driving. Feel the fact that, you know, the handling characteristic, the torsional rigidity is all there. And that's the feedback we've been getting. Everybody's been really surprised at how amazing it is that you give up nothing when you go to the open top. Beyond that, it is an open top. So the first thing I want to show you is the roof operation. Very simply, there's an icon right here on the center console that just looks like the car with the roof going up and down. Make sure you guys can hear me too.
Calculating route.
So there's this beautiful little ballet that happens behind my head. And it happens at up to 31 miles per hour in 19 seconds. So we wanted to make sure that our customers, even though they may not want to put the top up because they want to be driving the top down all the time, still had the ability to do it.
Please proceed to the route shown.
Very quickly, very easily. The top itself is actually triple layer acoustic insulated for heat and for acoustics. So if you have a chance to put it up during your drive today, again, you may not want to, it's such a beautiful day, but test it out. It's almost as quiet, almost identical in quietness to the coupe. So it's really amazing how far they were able to bring it. But if we're talking about quietness, I also want to talk about the other sounds that come from the car. I was asked yesterday, what did you do to the exhaust system to make it different on this car versus the coupe? I said, well guys, we didn't do anything at all. The clear fact is, with the top down completely unfiltered, we have a lot of insulation on the coupe just like you'd expect from Audi. Even that rear window on the coupe is insulated for sound. You have no filter for all of the beautiful noises that are gonna come from this engine. So, as you're driving, everywhere from, you know, low RPMs to high RPMs, you're going to hear the sound change, and that's really a great part of the driving experience for this car. And it's such a great part that our engineers made sure that they designed in an option that if you have the top up, you can still put this rear window down. I'll show you that real quick. So just underneath the top operation key fob here, or button here, you can put that up and down for a small windscreen.
And where's the holder for that?
Right here.
Thank you.
And it's also automatic, so you can put it up and down. That's a fully laminated, fully defrosting rear window that operates as the rear window when the top is up as well. So it's kind of an ingenious small thing that everybody came back yesterday and they're like, I can't believe how cool that was when we had to put the top up. You could still hear that beautiful exhaust note. Beyond that, I want to share with you a couple of innovative features specifically created for our Spyder customers. To begin with, these fine apple leather seats, these sport seats, are standard on the R8 V10 Spyder. Something particularly special about them is that they're thermal resistant. So even in direct sunlight, they'll reduce the temperature of the seats by up to 68 degrees. Another feature that we're very proud of at Audi is our world's first seatbelt mounted Bluetooth microphones. The purpose of these little discs they allow you, with even the top down, to have a Bluetooth conversation clearly. And I've tested it with the top down, windows down, up to highway speeds, and it still operates perfectly. It's really amazing. So I really recommend you guys try that out. To operate the Bluetooth and sync it up, you simply turn the car, cycle it off and then on. It's now into search mode. So take your Bluetooth phone and look for the signal. Once you pick it up, it'll say Audi, MMI, and then a number. The code's 1234 and you're synced up. It'll give you a little chime. Yeah, so I highly recommend trying that out. Beyond that, this is a rear bias car. It's rear bias in terms of the torque. It's rear bias in terms of the weight. It's a mid-engine car. So it has 57% rear weight bias. We also have an 85% rear torque bias in the quattro all-wheel drive system. So it'll act a lot like a rear-wheel drive car. The difference is it can also send up to 30% of the power up to the front wheels as needed. So for example, on the racetrack, if you guys have had the opportunity to drive the coupe, if you were to get this car out of shape and get the back end out, you're able to actually give it more power and pull the front wheels through the turn, through the drift. So it's something very unique about our cars, and really becomes fun if we get a little bit of rain, which with this open top, hopefully we don't. But that's the benefit if we do get a little rain, because you can play around a little more. Talking about playing around, this little suspension icon here is our Audi Magnetic Ride. You press it once and it says suspension sport mode on. That means that you're basically in a track setup suspension right now. Instantaneously almost, you press it again and it says sport mode off. It is close to a GT Touring compliance to give you that kind of comfort. ESP off button right here is very important. Who's driving a manual? It's got a manual. You guys got the manual. You guys got this car. I'm going to tell you guys, if you'd like to try it out, how launch control works. So I'm going to begin with the Artronic we have here. For the Artronic, you hit ESP off once. It says in the display, ESP Sport, warning, restricted stability. Two, you hit the Sport button. And three, you put your foot on the brake and the gas down to the floor. It'll hold at around 7,000 RPMs. You simply drop the brake and it'll launch you with optimal acceleration to 60, quarter mile, or whatever it is. The one thing that I would caution is make sure literally that there's nothing 100 yards in front of you when you do this, because it will happen fast. It's like being shot out of a cannon. It's a great experience, but just make sure there's nothing in front of you. On the manual version, it's even easier. You got a manual transmission, you hit that ESP once. Clutch, gas to the floor, and drop the clutch. It's as simple as that. It will hold at 7,000 RPMs. Now, this takes a little bit more nerve, but believe me, the system will do its job if this is operated properly.
What's the 0 to 60 time when you do that?
Four seconds flat. That also brings to mind the top speed, for example, is 195 miles per hour. That's only two miles per hour less than the coupe. So they were able to achieve a lot with this new concept. Beyond that, just for practicality purposes, we have a rear parking camera, as well as front and rear acoustic parking sensors. That'll come in handy when you guys come at your first stop. And with that, I hope you guys have a great drive.
Thank you.
Do you have any other questions?
The storage space is only on the front.
Yes, that's a good point. If you also, for picture's sake, or if you just don't like the visibility with this, it doesn't change the wind that much. It gives you a little bit more of a pocket, but not much. You can press this little push button here and here, and it simply slides off. The front storage compartment is a special area for it, so it doesn't slide around. You see right there. So we don't lose any front storage compartment space versus the coupe.
And our route is in the car?
The route's already set up. It's an hour and a half into the mountains, which is a great, great drive. It takes you about a half hour to get out of the city, but once you do, it's well worth it. And then it's about an hour and a half back down. Some people are switching at every waypoint that they put in there, where you can stop, take pictures. Up in the mountains is probably the best place to take pictures, because we have gotten a little marine layer. It may or may not be there when we get to the hotel. Or you can just switch at the halfway. For the bonnet, it's right here.
Oh, okay.
And for the engine compartment, which is just that section there. Unfortunately, because of the top of the carbon cover, that's all the engine that you get to see.
So you just say V10, there could be like two cylinders in there, and then way front to there.
After you drive, then we'll have to see.